Emperor Trebonienus Gallus is dead, and now another man rises to replace the late Imperator. Marcus Aemilius Aemilianus, known simply as Aemilianus or Aemilian, is going to be one of the briefest emperors the full Roman Empire will see. However, we must check his background first before going towards his death. Unluckily for us, his brief reign means that most historians use him as a stepping stool for Valerian, the next and more important emperor. However, there's still some information to be found in ancient sources, added to new modern hypotheses. The Epitome de Caesaribus locates Aemilianus's birthplace in Menynx, modern-day Girba or Yerba, an island currently on Tunis and previously on the Roman province of Africa. He is classified as a Moor or a Libyan in different sources, so I'll leave discussions regarding his ethnicity for another time and focus on his origins. It's very hard to find an ancestor for Aemilian. However, we know that none were of senatorial rank, or else some inscription would have mentioned a previous Marcus Aemilius. This goes in pair with the claims made by Eutropius that he was of very humble origins, although this has also been disregarded as simple defamation made against a brief emperor. Regarding his date of birth, there's once again various claims. The Epitome de Caesaribus mentions he was 47 at his time of death, this is, he was born at around 207. However, Zonaras claims he was 40. Regarding his family, all we know from numismatic evidence is that he was married to a certain Cornelia Supera, who was also given the rank of Augusta once Aemilian rose to power. Thomas Bancic mentions in his work that there's a certain inscription mentioning the empress in the area of Kouikoul, Algeria, but I haven't been able to find said inscription. However, as he mentions, this could mean that they got married before leaving Africa. They had no known children. And that would be all, really. Aemilian only comes to notoriety in 252. With his appointment as governor of Moesia and his fight against the gods that I already explained 2 videos ago. What relation did he have with Trebonienus Gallus? What cursus honorum did he go through, if he went through it in the first place? Many questions that will possibly go unanswered until a new inscription appears. Seeing how, after his death, a harsh damnatio memoriae was declared against him, it is very probable that we will never know. I can't even use a bust for his video, cause there's none, hence why I've used a coin in this and past videos. Thank you for watching.